गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इन आवर चैप्टर 7 आफ्टर द डबल एंट्री सिस्टम. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक द पार्ट्स ऑफ डबल एंट्री सिस्टम, देन एडवांटेज एंड डिसएडवांटेज एंड सम मोर डॉक्यूमेंट्स फॉर अकाउंटिंग. ओके बेटा, for that we are going to start with the part of double entry system. First is the original record. Actually in this double entry system, first we are going to enter the all head in the some different type of book, as like a journal, cash book, purchase book, sales return, purchase return. Okay, on these type of book we are going to make the record, so that we are calling that as the original record. There we are going to enter the entry form, that transaction in a entry form. We are going to present that transactions, the transaction which is done in the business, that we are going to present in the form of entry, in the form of journal, in the form of ledger. Okay beta, next classification. After the entered these all transactions in the different book, then we are going to make the ledger, or you saying going to open the ledger of the different account, open to ledger for the different account, and that is called classification. Because one type of account we are taking in one account, one type of head we are taking in another head. Okay, so that is called classification of accounts. Okay, next summary. After the making of this ledger, we are going to take the balance of that ledger and then making the trial balance. The balance we are going to take of that ledger, that is called summary. As like that, we are going to make a bit, many type of transaction with a cash, and then in classification we are making the classification, just account for the cash, debt, debit, credit, building account, furniture account and other accounts. So after that we are taking the balance of these all account, that is called summary. As like that, we are taking the balance of the cash account, and thus that cash balance is called the summary of this double entry system. We are going to following this summary of the accounts. Okay beta, of the all transactions which run in a business. Okay beta, clear? Now I'm going for the next topic, and next topic is advantage of double entry system. Okay beta, now we are going for the advantage of double entry system. First is the scientific system. This double entry system is like a scientific system, because in this system we are going to take the both side, debit and credit, all transaction both side, and we are going to present the all the head in the systematic way, following with the scientific rule and regulation, following with the some cause and effect relation, and these all type of scientific knowledge or scientific things we are going to utilize in our double entry system. It's prove the all type of many type of scientific things, so we can say it's a scientific process of double entry system. So in this double entry system, the advantage is we are utilizing the scientific system. So it's a scientific system. Okay, double entry system is the scientific system. Okay, next, complete record. In this double entry system, we are going to make the complete record from the starting of the transactions to ending of the financial year. Okay, up to that we are going to make the complete record. We are going to make the journal, we are going to make ledger, different account, cash book, sales book, purchase return, bill return, bill, bill receivable, bill payable, then depreciation bill of exchange. Okay, it means we are utilizing the all type of accounting. Depreciation we are utilizing for the assets account we are going to make, then trial balance, then final account, trading PL and balance sheet. It means in this accounting we are going to record the all complete record we are going to make in this part, then double entry system beta. Okay, by the utilizing of double entry system we can easily record the whole sole entry in our double entry system. So we can easily say by the utilizing of double entry system we can manage or maintain complete record. Okay beta, complete record. Okay, next is preparation of trial trading, and actually first we are going for the preparation of trial balance and then we are going for the preparation of trading and PL. No problem, it's just like a importance or advantage. So preparation of trial balance, in this double entry system we are going to make the trial balance. And trial balance is what? Trial balance is the statement which we are going to make for the knowing of arithmetical fault in our accounting. By the making of the trial balance we can easily know the mathematical type fault, as like a totaling fault, transferring fault, okay, doubling fault, okay, half amount entered fault. This type of fault we are easily identify the making of trial balance. Okay beta, by the making of trial balance. Okay, and that trial balance we are making in double entry system. So this double entry system is very useful for the all type of business or all type of accounting system or the business which going to utilize the or using the double entry system, for that is very beneficial. Okay beta, go for the next. Preparation of trading PL and balance sheet. In this double entry system we are going to make the trading PL and balance sheet, and in this trading we are easily know about the gross profit or gross loss. In PL we will know about the net profit or net loss, and in financial statement, that is financial position, that is balance sheet. Okay beta, the first we are going for this only, trading and PL. That trading and PL which we are going to make in double entry system, that is very good and that is very beneficial for the knowing of gross profit, gross loss, net profit, net loss of the business. By that the business will taking the decision or future decision very easily. Okay beta, by the making of trial balance we will know about our opening stock, closing stock, sales return, purchase return, all the direct expense, indirect expense, these all we are going to show in our trial balance, trading account and PL account. And by the showing of these all we are going to know about the gross profit or net profit. And after the knowing of this gross profit, less profit, net profit, we can easily utilize these all profit or accounting information for our business or by the our management. Okay beta, next, knowledge of financial position. In this double entry system we are going to make the balance sheet also. Okay beta, balance sheet. Okay, and by the making of balance sheet we can easily know the financial position of any business, because if we are going for the definition of balance sheet, the balance sheet definition is, balance sheet is the statement which we are going to make for the knowing of financial position of any business. They have two sides, assets and liability side. In asset side we are going to put our so fixed and current assets, liability side all type of liability, capital and current liabilities. Okay beta, and that system we are going to make in our double entry system. Then this double entry system is very beneficial, very useful for the business or for the accounting, because we are going to make the balance sheet, and by the making of balance sheet we will know about the financial position, because in this balance sheet we are going to maintain or make or show all the assets and all the liability, and by the showing of assets we can know about our all assets, and by the showing of liability we can know about our liability, and by the study of whole soul of that balance sheet we can easily know about the our financial position of the business. Okay beta, clear? Now go for the knowledge of various information. After that we are going to make the depreciation account, bill of exchange we can make in a double entry system. Okay, so these are what, these are given or more type of information and different type of information about the depreciation, about the assets, about the liabilities, about the business, by the utilizing of cash flow, by the utilizing of fund flow, by the utilizing of ratio, by the utilizing of comparative statement, we can take many type of information by this using of double entry system. Okay, next, lesser possibility of fraud. Actually in this double entry system we are just divide the all work in some person or more persons, 2, 3, 4 persons, and every person will done only own part, and next part done by the others, and next part do by the others. Okay, so the possibility of fraud is very less, because if one person is doing the something and doing any type of wrong thing, so that will check by the next person, if next, so that will check by the next person. Only fraud, if they are managed, the they want to managing the fraud or doing the fraud, then they, if all three will include for the doing the type of fraud, so that will okay. Otherwise the possibility of that fraud will very less, because one person work will check by the next person work will check by the next person, and by the checking of these all work, the possibility of fraud or any type of error will goes down, because the checking of the work is going on continuously. Okay beta, next, legal approval. After the making of double entry system, after the utilizing of this double entry system, we are going to make the all accounting record, and then that record will check by the CA or attest by the CA, then after we can easily just show this all accounting as a legal proof in court. Okay beta, as a legal proof in court, but after the checking are certified by the CA, we can easily, for any type of case is coming or any type of problem is coming against you, and that record is useful as a evidence, so you can easily show this record, and court will go with this record, or court will take this record as a evidence. Okay beta, then next, comparative study. In this double entry system we are making the all head, all the statement in a systematic way, then we are easily compare the all detail year by year or business to business. Okay, because in this double entry system you are also making the comparative statement, common size and comparative statement, two type of statement. Okay, that will come in 12th, not very okay, that both statement we can make in this double entry system, and by that we are easily compare the year to year or business to business. Okay, one year with the other year or one business to the other business. Okay beta, clear? Then help in decision making for the management. By the making of this all head in double entry system, all record in double entry system, we can easily give the information of financial position, profit and loss, trading and PL, your assets and liabilities, and by the knowing of this information or collecting of this information, management will easy to take the decision. Okay, next, suitable for all type of business. This double entry system is very flexible. We can utilize this double entry system for a very small business and very big company both. Okay, it's suitable for the all type of business. Okay, beta, clear? It's suitable for the all type of business. We can utilize this double entry system for the very very small type of business and very very big as like a company. From both we can utilize this double entry system. Okay beta, I think up to this is clear. Merit is clear. Okay beta, merit is clear or not? Then go for the next, disadvantage or merit. Okay, now disadvantage. Okay, because every system have advantage and disadvantage both. Okay, no system in world they have only advantage. Sure and certain they have some disadvantage. Okay beta, so first is error of omission. It's actually not the problem of double entry system, it's the problem of that person they are going to utilize or using this double entry system. Error of omission means you are not recorded that entry. If you are not recorded that transaction or entry, then we cannot utilize that transaction, and that transaction is not utilized in double entry system. So that is not the problem of double entry system, that is actual problem of the person they are going to utilize or using this double entry system beta. Okay beta, they are going to use this double entry system, their problem is that. But here for a subject matter, omission means we are not taking any transaction. If you are not taking any transaction, so then the double entry system is for you problems. Okay beta, that is the demerits or limitation of double entry system. Okay, next, error of commission. Here you are going to present wrong amount. Okay, you are going to present a wrong amount. Again I like to say, this is again the problem of the person. Wrong amount, you have entered the wrong amount. Transaction amount is 4820 and you are entered 4280. Okay, that type of problem you are facing. So that is problem coming in the double entry system. Then error of principle, again that is a problem of the person. If they didn't know about the principle of debit and credit and principle of different type of accounting, so when we are going to do the debit, when we are going to do the credit, where is debit, where is credit, what is assets, what is liabilities, what is current, what is fixed, then they are supposed to do some fault or do some error in our accounting. Okay, so if they didn't know or didn't have to well knowledge about the double entry system, they cannot do any type of entries. So that is the problem of principle or error of principles. Next, compensating errors. I think you will know about the compensate. If one error will compensate the other error, that is called compensate or compensating. Okay, that is called compensate or compensating. In this system, if one error will just compensate of other error, that is called compensating error. As like that, you are purchasing goods from Ram. 2000, okay, but entered in the question are in your accounting Shyam 2000, but total debtor is same, okay, total debtor is same, as like that total debtor is 4000, okay, on the place of Ram we are using Shyam, Shyam will add 2000, then 42000. It's wrong, but this Shyam will compensate off to the Ram, okay, but it's wrong, but our debtor is okay, our total of debtor is okay, no problem with the debtors. So that type of fault or that type of error is called compensative errors, okay beta, that type of error is called compensative errors, okay, clear, okay. Next, some source document, we are going for the some source document. First is the cash memo. When we are going to any shop and purchasing something in cash, then they are giving one receipt like that. Here cash memo is entered, here the amount like that, the name of the company or firm and then amount and signature place, that is called cash memo. Next is invoice and bill. When you are going to purchase on credit or different type of things, more things, then they are giving the different, just all the head written, the all the head, this amount, this things for this quantity, this thing for this quantity, this thing is this quantity, the rate is there, and the totaling amount, that is called invoice or bill. Receipts, when we are receiving from the money or receiving from the anything or receiving from the anything from any person, that thing is called receipts. Debit note, when we are going to return the goods to supplier, then we are going to make the debit note. When as a customer, as a businessman, we are going to return the goods to supplier, then we are in making the debit note. And when the others return to goods, or customer return to goods us, that time that credit note, okay, customer return to goods to us, that time credit note. Then pay in slip, this pay in slip you can see in bank. When you are going to bank and want to deposit the money, then you are going to fill up one form, the two side form is there, okay, fill the all detail, and with the money you are giving to that thing, to the banker or the person or cashier, they are just taking the one part and one part due to you, that thing is called paying slip. Check, what is the check? Check is the statement on which the owner signed there, and by that check the owner or account holder is given to the order to the banker to pay the amount which is entered in this check to the person whose name is entered there or who come with that check, okay. Check is the statement beta, check is the one statement or one page or one copy or one just a receipts in which the signature of owners means account holders, and by that the giving to the order to that bank, whose check is that, the amount which is entered in this check is paid to the person whose name is there on check or who is coming with that check. Okay beta. Next, voucher is the statement or first statement which we are making after the doing of transactions, and by the using of this vouchers we are going to enter the all transaction in our journal or our heads, our accounting, okay beta. First we are going to make the voucher after the transaction. Two type of vouchers there, cash voucher and non-cash. In the cash voucher, when cash transaction, for the cash transaction we are going to make the voucher, that is cash transaction, and for the non-cash transaction we are going to make the voucher, that is called non-cash voucher beta, okay. Next, in cash voucher two type of debit and credit, when we are going to make the voucher for paying, that is debit voucher, and when we are going to make the voucher for receiving, that is called credit voucher. Okay beta, when we are going to make for the receiving credit, giving or paying debit voucher. Okay beta, clear? All the thing is clear? Any type of doubt, just post in comment. In next class, I will try to clear that doubt. Okay, beta? Clear? Okay. Thank you.